peace, boxing fans. Thanks for pressing play on another Bite Down Boxing video. I'm the host here of the channel, R.L. Woodson or Just Wood, as well as the Bite Down Boxing with R.L. Woodson podcast that you can find on the Team Left Jab network. Hoping to put up a podcast tomorrow night. It'll probably be my final video on the whole Wilder Brazil fight coming up Saturday. Please go check out ByteDownBoxing.com. Put a little article up about the WBC champion, Deontay Wilder. I don't know how many of you saw his acting debut a couple weeks ago, but put a quick story together on that and just put some thoughts out there on Showtime, you know, everything that they've tried to do or everything that they've done to promote him and continue to raise, you know, his, or increase, you know, enhance his popularity and whatnot, the marketing and promotion of him. So please go check that out. Again, ByteDownBoxing.com, www.ByteDownBoxing.com. This is a topic. You know, I talk to myself a lot, so I'm basically just talking to myself out here. But the discussion comes back that, you know, Deontay Wilder is fight week up over in up in New York and in Brooklyn. And the video is out there that Deontay has once again said that, you know, he wants a body on his record. He may have even said this on First Take yesterday. What do we do with that? You get to a certain age, man, and I guess, you know, you got to make up your mind what battles you're going to fight, what hills you're going to die on. What do we ignore? I mean, words mean so much, and they mean something. And what we choose to throw out there, you know, they have an impact. They mean something. And I can make up my mind to disregard this statement that he's repeatedly made. I could just say it's a part of boxing. I can defend him. Some people are actually saying that it's the fans' fault. You know, fans root for knockouts and root for, you know, big shots, you know, heavy punches and whatnot, highlight reel knockouts. But now to expect, you know, the heavyweight champion of the world to exercise some restraint or exhibit some decorum, we can't do that. I don't really care, man. Again, and this is part of the reason. In one regard, I'm kind of with Dominic Brazil, man. In some ways, I'm growing a little sick of listening to some of the stuff that Deontay Wilder says. I'm sorry. The fact that you would go to in one episode of this All Access. I'm going to go to a civil rights museum and walk around statues of slaves and, you know, have some heartfelt moment with the imagery of this and whatever, you know, they have the plaques there to say something about what this statue represents or something. And you sit there and have a reaction to that. And then come in here and say, well, you know, but I'm going to kill this brother in the ring Saturday night. I'm going to kill this my opponent in the ring Saturday night who happens to be a black man. You got to, like, suspend your own intelligence with some of this stuff. But let's look at it like this. You know, the NFL had to step back and make a decision for its players and for player safety and from a PR perspective. You know, we're going to throw 50 passes apiece for both of these quarterbacks in this game. And on the other end of those 50 passes is 50 receptions And there could be, you know, 7 to 10 violent collisions waiting to happen based on the route and you know, the defensive player and all of that. And it's just for, it's somebody's life is on the line to catch this one ball. And it might not even be in the end zone. It might be first, it might be from the team's 1 yard line, who's driving down the field. They're on their 1 yard line, third and long, and they need to get to the 11 yard line or something for a first down or whatever. Third and long, they have to throw a pass. So that's those safeties, those DBs, they know what's coming. Now, if this if this offensive person catches this ball, it's a first down. It doesn't change the score. It doesn't win the game. It's just a first down. But we had men out here risking their lives to stop the other player from catching that ball. And I know I know they're trained to accept the reality of this situation and to accept that particular assignment on that particular play. But in the big scheme of things, you're risking your own health, a concussion, a spinal cord injury, and then you're possibly hurting this man. And the NFL had to come in and say, hey, man, we can't have people launching themselves into a defenseless person. Kickoff returns, punt returns. We can't have you come down and this man is looking to catch the ball and you just blow him up because you can. Like, they had to put rules in place to save these guys from themselves. That's how hard a human being can go to do this job. And a couple of times, you know, over these last year, you know, it's wide receivers that went to the Hall of Fame. You know, their whole legacy in football was because they were known for going over the middle and accepting whatever. But from the 80s and 90s up into the aughts and the teens, something really changed. You know, highlight reels, the ESPN making Sports Center, et cetera, that they totally got away from the whole spirit of football and what physical football was about. And a decision had to be made that, look, man, we just can't do that no more. Plus, we can't have these guys at 36 years old and their brains are mush. You know, we can't have 45-year-old men committing suicide because their brains are mush. The NFL, it can't all come back to us that we contributed to that situation. And so they changed it. And so now getting over here to boxing and with the heavyweight champion of the world repeatedly making this statement that I want a body on my record. We said here recently, Mike Alvarado against Barboza. You knew Alvarado was shot. He had no business being in there. You were glad that the referee did what he did. You know, nah, it's over with. Herrera against Virgil Ortiz a couple of weeks ago. Did you see how slow Herrera looked just when he was shadow boxing? Did you look at his body when he got in the ring? He had no business being in there. He took a serious shot. Brandon Rios, he was warned before Danny Garcia knocked him out. But he came back and had the bad loss to Canelo's brother. And then Soto just wore him out. And this man was still talking. They were still talking about putting him in against the best welterweights and even junior welterweight. We all see the updates on Pritchard Cologne. We saw Volchdik take out Adonis Stevenson and him coming back behind the scenes from his stuff. Like, we don't sit here, those of us that watch this game, man, we know what's on the line. But I never sat here and wanted anybody to be damaged. We can sit here and watch that graphic at the end of the HBO telecast. I don't know if Showtime does it. But we can sit here and see that a man took 110 headshots, you know, and you can sit here and make the direct correlation of that image, that graphic, and what punishment that man sustained that night, or you can leave it at the graphic and it mean nothing to you. But again, to sit here and say this and nobody's allowed to say that doesn't make sense or that's heinous or senseless or that's just inappropriate. We just don't need that in boxing. This is why I just kind of don't take the brother that serious, man. Like, what does that even mean? I want to catch a body. But, you know, that's what we do in the community, man. We don't admonish anybody for nothing. Very few of us. You know, nobody calls these guys out for doing inappropriate stuff or, you know, Muhammad Ali said it. You know, it's a shame that a man would get down the road 20, 30 years and never really understood that it, over the course of that time that you should mature and things that you used to do and things that used to be acceptable, you know, you have a different look on them. You have a better understanding, you know, you've made money. You know, you've changed your life. You changed your family's life. And then you get down the road and you don't show growth as a human being, as an adult. And you could say this is just to sell a fight. But then when they ask you 2 and 3 times, do you really mean it? And you double down on it or you restate it in a more affirmative way. You know, like I said, if I say anything, I'm just somebody sitting here hating on the man. I'm not hating on the man. I could care less. It's just, you know, it's almost like defending rap music. You know, Chris Rock had to joke about, you know, some of this stuff that they're saying nowadays, I just can't even defend it. And that's, you know, when the casual boxing fan happens to come across this type of stuff and you're sitting here wanting more people to get interested in the sport. And then, you know, something like this happens on ESPN or it's out here in the news. And somebody comes and asks you, well, what did he mean? You know, what? Hey, I don't know. That's on him. He said it. You know, check with him. Check with his people. Check with the people that support and follow him. I don't have nothing to do with that. And that's just how it is, you know. It's unfortunate. So enjoy the fight Saturday night. I'm sure it'll be exciting. I mean, I'm gonna check it out and everything, but it's again, I think, that's not the kind of headlines that a sport like boxing really needs. And it's part of the reason why I don't watch the UFC too tough because, you know, to sit here and choke a man or a woman till they turn purple or red, some of those submission holds, some of the knees and elbows to the head, that stuff is pretty savage to me. That's bare knuckle boxing. It's a reason why I get emails about bare knuckle boxing. Gabriel Rosado went over there to that. Paulie Malignaggi has something, you know, a fight coming up in bare knuckle boxing. I'm not tuning into that mess, but it's out there, and I understand with Mike Alvarado, Mauricio Herrera, Brandon Rios. I understand that that's their fighters. They feed their families with this stuff. I understand that. But again, it doesn't mean that we got to go along with it, that we have to advocate it, that we have to condone it. And you know, it's a shame. Even Saturday night at a certain point in Virginia, watching the fight with Jared Hurd and Julian Williams at a certain point. Seeing Jared Hurd take those shots earlier in the fight, I'm like, I really wonder, you know, if they need to stop this, you know. And a champion is going to get, be afforded the opportunity, you know, that's just part of boxing. I get it. But again, a lot of stuff is unwritten rules. And I think right here to make this statement repeatedly, I just think it's violating an unwritten rule. And it's a little ashamed if the champion doesn't see it that way. But, hey, It is what it is. Like I say, TIB, this is boxing.